So the Pope, I'm trying to see if I can find it for you real quick.
Oh, come on now.
I don't think I got it in this thing yet. Oh, yes, I do. Oh, look at this.
Teach, brother, teach.
Are y'all okay?
Yes, sir.
Did y'all see this? Y'all see this Pope fell? You see that? Now, to witness, then, what's your name, Sister Queen?
Georgia.
Sister Georgia, is that a white Pope?
No.
The Pope right there. That's the Pope. Mm-hmm. Look at Mary and Jesus. What color are they?
They're black.
Okay. Look at this one. This is the current Pope right here. Why he's with Pope Francis, getting sworn, Pope Francis getting sworn in. Look at what they're doing. Look at what they're bound in front of. Is that a black man?
Yeah, black too.
Did y'all see that?
Come on.
See, they know what color he really was. But they never want to teach us that he was this color.
Come on now.
Why? Because they know that lies destroy the brain.
That's right.
You didn't hear me.
Yes, sir.
And that all lies are not created equal. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that the brain has inside of it 14 billion brain cells.
Listen, listen.
And traveling around these brain cells in a circular motion from each cell, there is something called thought. And that thought travels on the average of 24 billion miles per second.
Come on.
And by the fact that thought traveling at 24 billion miles per second in a circular way inside of the brain or the mind of the human being, anything that spins produces two forces. Mm-hmm. One's called centrifugal force, and the other's called centripetal force. Centrifugal force means that when an object spins, it causes things to be thrown away from it. Centripetal means when the object spins, it draws things closer to it. So the merry-go-round. Now, if you from back in the day, whenever before Satan, before Xbox, y'all ever heard of a merry-go-round?
Yes, sir.
Come on now.
Come on now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You remember the merry-go-round, right?
Yes, sir.
You get on that thing, and then you got somebody spinning you real fast. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
And when you know you got a strong person on that thing, they tell you what? Hold on. Because if you don't hold on, when that thing spins, by the law of centrifugal force, it will throw you off.
That's right.
But another object spinning like a tornado, it doesn't shoot off away, pull stuff into it. So it is the power of thought. 24 billion miles per second, making circles around 14 billion brain cells, but it began to attract to itself thoughts, deeds, situations, circumstances, and people that are in accord with the nature of thoughts. And circumstances and people that are opposite the nature of your thoughts.
Come on.
So if a person is thinking negative thoughts, then they will repel positive people, situations, and circumstances.
Come on, baby.
If they are thinking positive thoughts, they will repel negative situations, people, and circumstances, and attract to themselves positive situations, people, and circumstances. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
You ever heard somebody tell you that your attitude will determine your altitude?
Yes, sir.
Meaning the mindset you have, be it positive or be it negative, that will determine how high you can rise.
That's right.
If you have a negative attitude, you always stay on a low level.
That's right.
But if you've got a positive mental attitude, then the altitude of positivity is unlimited. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad said that the universe that we live in is 76 quintillion miles in diameter.
Yes,
and if you think right, if you think positive, the diameter of the universe is a reflection of the diameter of the altitude you can reach.
Right.
There is no limit to your mind if you are thinking right.
Yes,
in fact, attitude is so important that if you were to take every letter of the word attitude and convert each letter to its numeric equivalent, A being one,
right,
T being whatever it is, and so forth, and add it all up together, attitude equals 100.
Do it.
Because attitude is 100%.
Right.
Of what you'll be, high or low. If you think weak, then you will attract weak people to you.
Right.
If you think weak, then you will attract weak circumstances and events to you.
Yes, sir.
But if you think positive, you think powerful, you think strong, you will attract positive and strong people. into your life.
Yes,
y'all still with me?
Yes, sir.
I don't know how I got on that point. Oh, our lives are not created either.
Yes, sir.
So when they told us that Christopher Columbus discovered America, that's a lie.
Yes, sir.
The most honorable Elijah Muhammad said that the brain cell was created to think right.
Well, that's right.
Right meaning correct.
Yes, sir.
But right also could be a direction. Right?
Yes, sir.
If something is moving in a right motion in a circular way, we call that clockwise.
Right.
True?
Yes, sir.
Don't you know that if you have thought moving at 24 billion miles per second and it was created to go a certain direction, every time you tell the brain a lie, it is like sending that thought into reverse.
Right.
Teach, brother. Teach.
If you were driving a car at full speed, and every time you got it to full speed, you slammed it into reverse, at a certain point, you're going to throw out the what?
Transmission.
Transmission. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
What is the transmission in your car for?
Well,
it is designed to shift you from one gear to the next gear.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, yes sir.
If you don't have a good working transmission, I don't care how pretty the car is.
Go ahead.
I don't care how big the rims are. I don't care how nice this music sounds.
Come on,
push the seats up.
Go ahead.
Even if the engine is working good.
Right.
If you don't have a transmission that operates, you can hit the gas and it's going nowhere.
Go ahead, sir.
Is that the truth?
Yes, sir.
At a certain point when your transmission begins to slip, then not only because sometimes can you go nowhere, but you might get stuck in first gear.
Yes, sir.
In first gear, you don't go past 20 miles per hour.
Come on.
But if you've got a goal to get from here to a certain place at a certain amount of time, it might require you to go 55 miles per hour for 10 minutes to get there in 10 minutes. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
But if the transmission is messed up,
well,
then you can't get out of first gear, which means that you began to move too slow.
Yes, sir.
To get to your goal at said time.
Yes, sir.
So it is with the human brain.
Right.
Come on. Come
the
on.
The more lies that are told to the human brain,
listen.
We began to mess up the transmission.
Yes, sir. Mm.
See, every voluntary act of the human body first starts off as a thought.
Yeah.
And that thought inspires the body to produce the appropriate feeling.
Uh-huh.
And then that feeling encourages the body to engage in the appropriate muscular activity.
Right.
Come on,
that matches the command coming from that brain. But if the transmission is messed up, you can hit the gas, but it won't go into the gear. So we were told that Christopher Columbus discovered America, but there are already Indians here.
Come on,
yes, sir.
That's a lie.
That's right.
We were told that George Washington chopped down a cherry tree, right? And he never told a lie. That's a lie. Not only was George Washington a liar, but all the founding fathers were originally prisoners in England.
That's right.
You didn't hear me. Thomas Jefferson and George Washington, John Hancock, all the founding fathers were let out of the prisons in Europe.
Wow.
Sent to America to start need gun control.
Yeah.
Here you are, America with the greatest military budget of anybody on earth.
Go ahead, go ahead.
America has more weapons than anybody on earth. Well, what if China said we need some gun control? Yeah, it's quiet now.
Yeah.
All the money that America spends on military, do you know they got enough military weaponry to blow up the world 100 times?
Come on now.
Why do you need that much military weapon to keep on spending?
Come on, man.
They, y'all, look at them, they killing each other over drugs. Well, why were you in Afghanistan?
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Talk about.
See, in Afghanistan, they have something growing called the poppy seed.
Yeah.
The poppy seed is where they produce heroin from.
That's right.
Now, the Taliban was in control of Afghanistan. They didn't let the poppy seed get out to be used as a drug.
Come on.
But all of a sudden, heroin is back in America.
That's right.
Soon, the Taliban's gone.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, after Afghanistan has been bombed back into the Stone Age, now all of a sudden, heroin's jumping again.
Come on, yes, sir.
Well, where did it come from? It came from them fighting and killing over the drugs over there.
That's right, sir.
Ain't that something?
Yes, sir.
They tell you that you shouldn't. You know it, you know you. Look at this, it's a shame. Man, they shot something. Man got shot over some Jordans. Man got shot over some rims. People killed each other over material objects and money. Well, then why did you fight every war that America's fought? Why come every war you fought has oil attached to it somehow?
Come on, man.
Wrong way.
Why come America hasn't ever gone to the Sudan to fix that problem?
Right, sir.
Because there's not no oil there for.
Right.
Why come America didn't go to Rwanda whenever there was genocide and still genocide going on?
Jeez,
why come America didn't go to Darfur?
Come on.
See?
Right.
See, no, you are quick to go to Iraq.
Yeah.
You're quick to go to Libya. You're quick to go to Egypt because you know that these are oil producing nations.
Come on, right?
You're quick to try to jump on and pounce on Iran because Iran is an oil producing nation.
Right.
Whenever white people say on that dollar that in God we trust, they're not talking about the same God you and I believe in.
That's right.
They're not talking about Jesus or Yahweh or Jehovah or Allah or the Lord of the world, the supreme being. They're not talking about the creator of all things, the sender of all prophets.
That's right.
And the revealer of all truths.
Come on now.
When they talk about God, they are using God, G-O-D, as an acronym. It stands for gold, oil, and drugs.
Drugs.
Y'all all right?
Yes, sir.
So they told us that Abraham Lincoln freed the slave.
Come on now.
Lie.
That's right.
Yes, all this is messing up our transmission in our brain.
Yes, sir.
Y'all still with
us? Yes, sir.
So we always say, what things need to change?
Right.
Yeah, but the things that need to change, God, there's no mystery God in outer space, it's going to change.
Right.
No, if this, things are going to change, they're going to be changed because what we say.
Yes, right.
Because of what we envision.
That's right.
Because of what we did with these hands. There is no change coming unless we do it for ourselves.
That's right.